The trend of sericulture development in India clearly depicts a quantum jump in mulberry silk production during the last 3 decades. Renita was high in 1960 at 16 to 17, which came down to 7 to 8 in 2000. This was possible mainly because of advancement made in the field of silkworm breeding, rearing technology, improvement of mulberry genotypes, and mulberry cultivation practices. Till recently, India had no system of authorization of silkworm breeds, which caused undue delay in release of breeds, hybrids evolved by the breeders with great caution. This also deprived industry from the benefits of having wider choice of silkworm hybrids for commercial exploitation. Central Silk Board has brought out a system of authorization of silkworm races. The system involved 14 test centers spread in different regions of the country, and test rearing are conducted twice in a year. Silkworm hybrids authorized by CSB for commercial exploitation. Silkworm Bombyx moree L, the source for production of fabulous silk and sericulture industry, has been domesticated more than 4000 years ago. Its adaptability to environmental conditions in different forms of the wild insects and the rearing techniques are varied to suit the requirements under different ecological conditions. To find out more about business viability of silk production, it is linked to sericulture as a business, and find out more about growing mulberry to feed silkworm. Like other widely distributed animals, the mulberry silkworms reared in more than 30 countries of the world are differentiated into a number of genetically distinct races. Being a strictly domesticated and commercially exploited animal, each country is actively engaged in evolving new breeds or varieties of Bombyx moree by crossbreeding of native and exotic races. In Japan alone, more than 2000 genetically identical races are maintained. In India, there are 200 races maintained in its different breeding center, and only a broad-based classification of breeds are attempted in this chapter. The present study is intended to collect all the available details on the breeds and trace their lineage so as to make the present text serve as a source material for the improvement of silkworm varieties in future. The practical lineage of breeds referred in this context actually means the lineage of silkworm breeds. The characteristics and the quality of these varieties from the practical point of view. This study also elucidates the interrelationship among the breeds. During the period when the concept of silkworm breeds was not clearly defined, the term silkworm breeds was not as restricted as it is now, but was casually used to indicate the variety and type. Guidelines for the basic seed form. Seed organization comprises mainly maintenance of breeder stock and its multiplication at various levels of the ultimate production of large quantity of commercial seed. Therefore, the maintenance of breed characteristic is of utmost importance. The breeder stock maintenance should be the responsibility of breeders of research institute, which in turn should supply the basic stock for the maintenance and multiplication of the parental breeds. The basic seed form should adhere to the following guidelines to produce quality and seed conforming to the original breed characteristics. In India, over 95% of the commercial silk being produced from multivoltaic female into bivoltaic male parents, and the existing crossbreed is pure Mysore into NB4D2, as some limitation, especially low sulfate, high rendita, low cocoon cell ratio, and poor fiber quality. Characteristic of pure Mysore. Fecundity rate is low, ranging from 350 to 400x. They produce more than 5 to 6 generation in a year. Larval duration is 28 to 30 days. Leaf cocoon ratio is high. Shape of the cocoon is spindle and produce deep yellow colored cocoons. preparation rate is 72 to 75%. Cocoon weight is 0.8 to 1 gram. Cocoon cell weight is 0.30 to 0.35 gram. Cocoon cell ratio is 18 to 20%. Raw silk is 15 to 17%. Filament length is 500 to 550 meters. Rendita is 12 to 30. The larvae can tolerate fluctuating environmental conditions. Characteristics of NB4D2. Color of the mature larvae are plain faint bluish. Fecundity rate is low, ranging from 475 to 550 hex. They produce only 2 generations in a year. Larval duration is 24 to 25 days. Leaf cocoon ratio is low. Shape of the cocoon is elongated, constricted with round end and produce white colored cocoons. Pupation rate is 75 to 80%. Cocoon weight is 1.5 to 1.6 gram. Cocoon cell weight is 25 to 28 gram. Cocoon cell ratio is 19 to 20%. Raw silk is 22 to 24%. Filament length is 850 to 900 meters. Rendita is 6 to 7, denier is 2.3 to 2.4. Characteristics of NB18. Color of the mature larvae are plain, faint bluish. Fecundity rate is low, ranging from 475 to 550 hex. They produce only 2 generations in a year. Larval duration is 24 to 25 days. Leaf cocoon ratio is low. Shape of the cocoon is elongated, constricted with round end and produce white colored cocoons. Pupation rate is 75 to 80%. Cocoon weight is 1.5 to 1.6 gram. Cocoon cell weight is 25 to 28 grams. Cocoon cell ratio is 19 to 20%. Raw silk is 22 to 24%. Filament length is 850 to 900 meters. Rendita is 6 to 7. Denier is 2.3 to 2.4. Cross between PM into NB4D2. In order to overcome the limitations of PM into NB4D2, new hybrids involving multivoten breeds have been evolved. The salient features and characteristics of breeds are narrated below. Fecundity rate is ranging from 475 to 525 hex. Larval marking is sex limited gray is white. Larval duration is 25 to 26 days. Shape of the cocoon is oval and produce yellow colored cocoons. Pupation rate is 75 to 80%. Cocoon weight is 1.60 to 1.70 gram. Cocoon cell weight is 0.40 to 0.5 gram. Cocoon cell ratio is 22 to 24%. Raw silk is 17 to 19%. Filament length is 800 to 900 meters. Denier is 2.2 to 2.4. Rendita is 7 to 8. Cross between BL23 into NB4D2. This hybrid is meant for rain-fed areas like Chamarajanagar and Kollagal of Karnataka. In these areas, at present, multivoten hybrid PM into C. Nichi is being prepared by the farmers, which is very poor in quantitative and qualitative traits. The hybrid is better over PM into C. Nichi in cocoon weight, cell ratio percentage, filament length, rendita, and neatness. The hybrid is developed by Central Sericulture Research and Training Institute, CSRNTI, Mysore. Cross between BL24 into NB4D2. This hybrid is meant for irrigated areas in all the seasons and is superior over the existing hybrid in yield, cocoon weight, cell ratio percentage, filament length, raw silk percentage, neatness and rendita. The hybrid is developed by CSRNTI Mysore. Characteristics of BL23 breed. Newly laid eggs are yellow in color. Color of the mature larvae are plain bluish white. Fecundity rate is ranging from 460 to 490 hex. Larval duration is 22 to 24 days. 15 stars larval duration is 5 to 6 days. Duration from the spinning to moth emergence is 10 to 12 days. Cocoon color is greenish yellow color, elongated oval shaped. Cocoon weight is 1.20 to 1.40 gram. Cell weight is ranging from 18 to 23 gram. Cell ratio is ranging from 15 to 16%. Silk filament length is 475 to 500 meter. Characteristics of BL24 breed. Newly laid eggs are yellow in color. Fecundity rate is ranging from 408 to 500 eggs. Color of the mature larvae are plain bluish white. Larval duration is 22 to 24 days. Fifth instar's larval duration is 5 to 6 days. Duration from spinning to moth emergence is 10 to 12 days. Cocoon color is greenish yellow color, elongated oval shaped. Cocoon weight is 1.20 to 1.40 gram. Cell weight is 20 to 24 gram. Cell ratio is 16 to 17%. Silk filament length is 475 to 500 meters. Cross between BL23 into NB4D2. BL23 and NB4D2 characterized by its robustness, high cell weight, high silk content, long filament length, and better neatness and reliability in comparison to PM into C-Nichi. Larvae are plain, bluish white in color. Cocoons are light greenish yellow and intermediate in shape between oval and constricted. Fifth instar larval duration is only 5 to 6 days. Total larval duration is 22 to 23 days. It gives higher cocoon yield than existing hybrid PM into C. nichi. Cocoons of little color shade variation, which however does not affect fiber quality. Flash with reference to cocoon shell is less, recommended for rainbed areas. Cross between BL24 into NB4D2. BL24 into NB4D2 characterized by its robustness, high cell weight, high silk content, long filament length, and better neatness and reliability. Larvae are plain, bluish white in color. Cocoons are light greenish yellow and intermediate in shape between oval and constricted. Fifth instar's larval duration is only 5 to 6 days. Total larval duration is 22 to 23 days. Leaf silk conservation is very high compared to PM into NB4D2. Rendita is about 8. It gives 10 to 15% higher cocoon yield than existing hybrid PM into NB4D2. Cocoons show little color shade variation, which, however, does not affect cocoon quality. Recommended for rain paid area. Keeping in view production of quality silk, the breeding work was started at CSRNTI Mysore by scientists of Central Silk Board, Ministry of Textile, with the support of the Japan International Cooperation Agency under Bivoltaic Culture Technology Department project, by utilizing two Japanese commercial hybrids, has resulted in the evolution of highly productive CSR breeds. During the course of breeding of high raw silk recovery, robustness and production of cocoons with high quality silk were mainly considered. The full potentiality of these hybrids can be realized only when optimum inputs to mulberry and good rearing management are assured. Therefore, they are recommended for rearing during favorable seasons in southern India and during spring in temperate subtropical zones, with selected farmers having assured irrigated mulberry gardens. The new hybrids are better over the Czech hybrid KA into NB4D2 in terms of cocoon weight, shell ratio, raw silk percentage, filament length, and neatness. Characteristics of Central Silkworm races, CSR races. Fecundity rate is ranging from 500 to 550 eggs. Larval marking is plain, bluish, and white. Larval duration is 23 to 24 days. The shape of the cocoon is oval and produces white colored cocoons. Pupation rate is 85 to 90%. Cocoon weight is 1.80 to 1.95 gram. Cocoon cell weight is 0.45 to 0.50 gram. Cocoon cell ratio is 24 to 26%. Raw silk is 19 to 20%. Filament length is 1000 to 1100 meters. Denier is 3 to 3.15. Cross between CSR2 into CSR4. Fecundity rate is ranging from 550 to 600 hex. Larval marking is plain, bluish white. The shape of the cocoon is oval and produces white colored cocoons. Pupation rate is 96.5%. Cocoon color is white. Cocoon weight is 1.80 to 1.90 gram. Cocoon cell weight is 0.43 to 0.50 gram. Cocoon cell ratio is 23.5%. Raw silk is 20%. Filament length is 1100 to 1200 meters. Reliability is 85%. Rendita is 5. Cross between CSR2 into CSR5. Fecundity rate is ranging from 500 to 550 hex. Larval marking is plain, bluish white. The shape of the cocoon is oval and produces white colored cocoons. Pupation rate is 96.5%. Cocoon color is creamy white. Cocoon weight is 1.80 to 1.90 gram. Cocoon cell weight is 0.43 to 0.50 gram. Cocoon cell ratio is 23.5%. Raw silk is 20%. Filament length is 1100 to 1200 meters. Reliability is 79%. Rendita is 4.8. Cross between CSR3 into CSR6. Fecundity rate is ranging from 500 to 600 hex. Larval marking is sex limited, bluish white. The shape of the cocoon is oval. Pupation rate is 94%. Cocoon color is creamy white. Cocoon weight is 1.80 to 1.90 gram. Cocoon cell weight is 0.43 to 0.50 gram. Cocoon cell ratio is 24.5%. Raw silk is 19.8%. Filament length is 1290 meters. Reliability is 81%. Rendita is 5. Cross between CSR12 into CSR6. Fecundity rate is ranging from 500 to 500 hex. Larval marking is sex limited, bluish white. The shape of the cocoon is oval. Pupation rate is 91%. Cocoon color is creamy white. Cocoon weight is 1.80 to 1.90 gram. Cocoon cell weight is 0.43 to 0.50 gram. Cocoon cell ratio is 23.5%. Raw silk is 19.9%. Filament length is 1200 meters. Reliability is 82%. Rendita is 5. Keeping the field requirement in view, KSO1 and SP2 have been evolved with main emphasis on robustness. These races have been bred utilizing South Korea, Taiwanese Bivolten, NBPR-D2 and pure Mysore races are adopting hybridization and selection method. The pure races are characterized by medium cocoon weight, yield, size and silk percentage. The larval duration is 23 to 24 days and is shorter by 1 to 2 days compared to existing hybrids. The hybrids, that is KSO1 into SP2, have better hybrid vigor, robustness and productivity. The new hybrid can tolerate higher temperature and thus can be reared during unfavorable seasons also. The new hybrids can be reared by an average crossbred farmer and can realize better cocoon yield and returns. Characteristics of KSO1. Fecundity rate is ranging from 450 to 500 hex. Larval marking is plain, bluish white. Larval duration is 23 to 24 days. The shape of the cocoon is site constriction and produce a white colored cocoons. Pupation rate is 88 to 93%. Cocoon weight is 1.40 to 1.70 gram. Cocoon cell weight is 0.28 to 0.33 gram. Cocoon cell ratio is 19 to 20%. Raw silk is 16.1%. Filament length is 800 to 900 meters. DNR is 2.3. Characteristics of SP2. Fecundity rate is ranging from 450 to 500 eggs. Larval marking is plain, blue is white. Larval duration is 23 to 24 days. The shape of the cocoon is short and produces white colored cocoons. Pupation rate is 85 to 90%. Cocoon weight is 1.30 to 1.50 gram. Cocoon cell weight is 0.28 to 0.32 gram. Cocoon cell ratio is 19 to 20%. Raw silk is 16%. Filament length is 850 to 950 meters. DNR is 2.2. Cross between KSO1 into SP2. Fecundity rate is ranging from 475 to 525 eggs. Larval marking is plain, blue is white. Larval duration is 24 to 25 days. The shape of the cocoon is short and produces white colored cocoons. Pupation rate is 90 to 95%. Cocoon weight is 1.60 to 1.90 gram. Cocoon cell weight is 0.32 to 0.42 gram. Cocoon cell ratio is 20 to 22%. Raw silk is 18 to 20%. Filament length is 1000 to 1100 meters. DNR is 2.4. Depending upon the breeds, a silkworm has its natural resistance to flatulency, grassery and muscard. It is also possible to breed such resistant strains. It is most desirable to breed a strain resistant to any of these important diseases. In fact, such strains are available or even can be especially bred. However, the crucial problem is whether it will be possible to obtain a strain having the same level of the other useful characters, for example, those relating to the different measurements of cocoon as in the existing strains, and at the same time have high resistance to the various important diseases.